like everything about you.
Hello everyone and welcome to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. My name is Francesco D'Alessio and welcome back to another video. So today we are looking at the Trello power-up, which is called Butler for Trello. Butler spelt B-U-T-L-E-R. And this application essentially is a workflow automation application for Trello and can be installed inside of any free Trello account. And what I want to do today is demonstrate this experience and giving you a bit of an overview of what it actually does, as well as the pricing and information that you need to know. So just to be clear, we're going to be looking at the free version of the Butler experience inside of this video today, so check out the pricing below, which will be in the description, as well as at the end of the video. So here we are, this is my board, so just showing my board, the board for video calendar, which I use for my YouTube videos to tally up the ones that I've already done, as well as the ones that I have planned for the future. And as you can imagine, to some extent, that can get pretty messy. And the reason why I'm going to demonstrate on this sort of board today is because this is my most active board inside of my Trello experience. So as you can see here, the Butler experience is available in the top right hand corner. You click into it and it'll bring you up this experience first. Now, just to let you know, Butler does require permissions via Trello. So once you get started, you'll have to allow that to get access to the account. Now, I want to start off with rules because I think rules is a pretty neat area that will save you a bit of time. As you can imagine, when you're starting up an account, you're doing a few processes. Like for example, I know when I create a new card for the future, I'm always tending to be adding a label to it, which is yellow, because yellow is my indication that I have yet to film it. And as you can imagine, it sort of adds up when you're sort of like creating a card, then adding a label to it automatically. That sort of builds up. So this is a rule that you can create for any of your experiences. For this demonstration, I'm actually using it for community ideas. So I have a, I have a community ideas tab here with any ideas that the community can add to this board, this list, inside of the board, and all of those ideas appear here. So I've created a rule to essentially make sure that I'm always aware of this. So for example, you can see here, I can edit this one to demonstrate that the trigger is whenever a card is added to this list here by anyone, and you can obviously set that by me or by anyone, then automatically the actions are from the trigger is to add a yellow, label, which is to film, to it, and automatically join the card. So this is very helpful. You can add one or multiple actions to a specific card, which is quite useful, and a specific rule. So for example, I could add more modifications. I could add it to an additional label, remove a label, can do absolutely anything, add a sticker to it, and even look at completion, and also as well as whether I need to subscribe to it or move it to different areas. So that's quite helpful. So let me demonstrate how this one works in practice. So for example, let's say somebody pops along and they go, okay, you know, I want to do a video on the freelancing apps to use. And I select off it. You can see automatically the label has been created, which is pretty cool. So that's an instant one. And as you can see here, I've just joined it without any need. So for example, if anybody in the community comes on and they type away, they'll automatically know it's been assigned to me to take a look at. And of course, then I get a notification through my phone that I need to check this one out, which is very helpful. So if I know that anyone else has come on and on board and actually done that. So that's rules inside of Butler. Inside of Butler, you only get one rule per type. So that's one limited one command for the free plan, but you do obviously get an extended experience there. So I want to demonstrate the card buttons. Card buttons are a way to add additional cards, buttons inside of a card. So these will appear inside. So for example, if I go to this one, you can see here the power-up adds an extra button. This is quite cool. So when I press this button, the modification will come in. So let me just demonstrate it how I've done it. So let me scroll across to this video here. So I've just put up Software Pulse, which is the weekly news segment. Now, if I click into it, it has got a due date because yesterday I had a due date to it and I wanted to know that that's important there. So the card button has been created to remove the due date automatically. So if I click this one, the due date should go. There we go, the due date goes automatically. And that just, to some extent, avoids me doing this, change due date, remove. So you've got a button specifically designed for that. And of course, this is really, maybe not so amazing example of it, but as you can see here, if I click edit, the title, I've titled it due date's gone, and you can add the certain action. And you can add lots more actions to it. So if you press that button inside there, it would do a multitude of things, allowing you a lot more access, which is very, very helpful. So that's just something to note. And of course, you can add many more of those areas there. Now, you're probably wondering, what's a board button? What differs from that? So for example, you can simply have a board button, and the board button will sit at the top right here. So whenever I press this one, something will happen, which is quite cool. An action will happen in the board. In this demonstration, I hate sometimes when it does that. In this demonstration, whenever I press test, it will automatically run the query and create testing with a label and me attached to it. So that's something that you can demonstrate. So for example, you could, I don't know, add like new task or I don't know, something that really benefits your, so let's say you had this as an inbox, let's say you wanted to create a new thing, or you could just have a fixed board query. So for example, if you wanted to maybe sort something based on dates, for example, then you could do that all the way through there, which is very helpful. So if I go to board dates, you can edit it here, and you could obviously add as many actions as you want. So you can create even new lists. You can arrange boards. So for example, if you wanted to arrange boards based on descending order, then you could do that as well. That's really helpful. You could move certain cards along, which is quite helpful, or you could sort them based on more detailed stuff like list name and due date. So for example, if you wanted to get really detailed, you can do this. Now, just a note as well, when you create one of any of the board buttons or cards, you get these lovely icons which you can add to it. So for example, if I changed it to that and saved it, then you can see in the top right corner, the nice thumb comes up there. So one final area that you're probably wondering is, what is scheduled? Scheduled is essentially a place where you can organize time or date-based things inside of your Trello account. So for example, what it will do here is you can set this to every single day, it to create a new card titled idea, you can see it here, in the list community ideas. And this could be useful if you've got like, if you're using this for a to-do list, for example. Let's say you have, I don't know, a to-do list for today, a list for today called today, and you want, you know, the date of the day actually, or day's tasks available inside of today. Or even something routine, like routine tasks, ready for you to add more detail to. And of course, you can add and edit what actions you exactly have, and they're very similar to the actions that are available in the board button. And you can change the trigger too. You can have it for every 2 weeks, every 3 weeks, and you want to add routine tasks to it. Let's say you want to add like check MOT, I don't know, things like that. Then of course, you can do that quite quickly. And also you've got due date as well. I haven't actually started this one up yet. You can create a due date. So for example, wait, let me just sort of get my head around this because I actually haven't checked this one out yet. But basically, you can get a notification. That's what it was. You can get a notification. For example, let's say you had like loads of different cards and you want to set a due date trigger on those cards, like to be notified 2 days before the due day, then you can do that. And that's very helpful. So that's something you can do, even the moment the card is due, 2 days before, on how many working days. And you can add an advanced level two based on filtering, which can get very intricate. So if you're looking for intricacy, head there. But as you can imagine, inside of this experience, it's very limited in the free plan. The free plan has some commands that you can only set one command per type, per area, which is a bit of a sort of fallback. So we have the free account here. Let me just overview the pricing. So the free account, obviously no credit card required. You have up to 25 command runs per week. And the way that you check this is you simply go to usage log, and it says your weekly quota is 25 commands, runs, and 250 operations. You've used 10 command runs and 15 operations so far this week. So it allows you to keep a tally of all of your activities. And that's per week, so they'll obviously renew every single week, and they'll tell you when you're hitting your usage limit. Now you get limited commands, one of each type, as well as customer support naturally. The other thing that you do have is two pricing plans. You have team pricing plans as well. I won't talk about that in this video. If you want to go crazy with this and more advanced, you can set up 250 command runs per week and 2,500 operations per week, as well as multiple commands and priority support. And that's $10 per month, billed annually, as well as a silver, as well as an annual price for that silver platter service, as well as royal treatment, which is double that price at $20 per month, but gives you 1,000 and 5,000 operations per week. So that is much more intricate. But as you can imagine, if you really want to hack your Trello account to crazy, like you want to take all of the details on the boards and make it really intricate, then that is where you're going to be sort of pricing the information. So guys, hopefully that was a nice overview of Butler for Trello. Let me know in the comments below whether you're using it. It'd be great to hear if you have any workflow set up there. In the future, I will probably explore this in more detail. For example, like how you should use it in a to-do list situation. If you are using to-do list, Trello is your to-do list, or even with some specifics. And personally, I will be exploring how to do certain things inside of it. This might be a bit of a bad example because I've got tons of lists inside this board. It's a very list focused board because I've got all the previous stuff and all the future stuff. So list titles are always changing. Like for example, I need to change June 03 to June 03 because there's a duplicate there. But as you can imagine, that's really how advanced you can get with it. Anyway guys, thank you so much for stopping by today. Make sure to hit subscribe if you're brand new and leave a comment if you have any notes below. Anyway guys, thank you so much for stopping by today. Make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon.